Finally tonight, our NewsHour share, something that caught our eye that might be of interest to you, too. In 2012, a NewsHour colleague suggested historian Michael Beschloss create a Twitter profile to share what interested him most. Since then, Beschloss has provided a unique perspective on American history, often through photos, to his more than 140,000 followers. He spoke with us recently about some of his favorite posts.
I do a lot of historical photographs, but with a relevance to today. Try to find things that people have not seen before, but also things that remind us that there is a history to some of the events and people we're seeing now. This is John Kennedy, 1954, with his wife Jackie, sister-in-law Ethel, taking an early version of what we now call selfies, in this case in a mirror. Louis Armstrong in 1961 was playing in Egypt, and a photographer got the wonderful idea of taking him and his wife to the pyramids and the Sphinx. This is really eerie. These are the contents of Abraham Lincoln's pockets on the night that he was murdered. The most amazing thing here is that among the things that Lincoln was holding the night he died was a $5 Confederate bill. And sort of amazing when you think about the fact that nowadays the United States $5 bill has a picture of Abraham Lincoln. Six first ladies backstage an event, 1994, Nancy Reagan, Lady Bird Johnson, Hillary Clinton, Rosalind Carter, Betty Ford, Barbara Bush. Take a look at the relationships among them, shows you how one photograph can speak volumes. Babe Ruth was knocked out unconscious during a game in 1924. Was out for about 5 minutes, and this was a very different time. He went back into the game and played. It was a doubleheader. He played another game that day. Would not happen today. This is a report card that John Lennon got when he was 16 years old, and what his principal said of him was, he has too many of the wrong ambitions, and his energy is often misplaced. Marilyn Monroe went to Korea in 1954 to perform for troops. She had a Pentagon ID, which shows her married name at the time, which was Norma Jean DiMaggio. 1865, New York, Abraham Lincoln's funeral parade through the city of New York, and up in the window, upper left in that circle, is a six-year-old Theodore Roosevelt looking down for the rest of his life. He was affected by this. When he was president, he said, I used to ask myself, what would Lincoln do? This is Harry Truman in the late 1930s having a gun pulled on him by Vice President John Nance Garner. They thought it was a big joke in those days. Take a look at this image nowadays. A vice president doing this would not be seen as so funny. When I began doing this, I thought I would be on Twitter for about a week because I thought there would be about three people who would be interested in looking at old pictures. And the amazing thing was that within a week, the number of followers really went up very steeply. And since then, I have found that there are a lot more people interested in history in America in general, and particularly our visual history, than I realized.
He's worth the follow. You can follow Michael's photos on Twitter at BeschlossDC.